Teenage abuse of prescription drugs is being called an emerging epidemic. Now some top government officials are trying to shed a little light onto that problem. KCRA3's Brian Hickey live at the federal courthouse now with what they're trying to do.
Well, Deirdre, you know, so often parents try to protect their kids from the drug dealer on the corner, but now this new problem, the drugs are already in the house, and it's the parents that are so-called providing them by not locking them up, and kids are getting into them now. Take a look at the numbers, and you can see why they're calling this an emerging epidemic. One in five kids has tapped into their parents' painkillers. One in five has gotten into the stimulants and the tranquilizers. One in 10 has abused cough medication. So I bet your kids have more than 5 or 10 friends, so the chances are they know somebody who's abusing these prescription drugs. And today there's going to be a press conference here at the federal courthouse. This is Teri Christensen with the Partnership for a Drug-Free America and McGregor Scott, the U.S. attorney here at the federal courthouse. And first off, calling this an epidemic, I mean, has it really come to that?
Well, it's an epidemic because our concern, Brian, is that the numbers we're looking at today potentially could double. So when you've got 4.5 million kids that tried prescription drugs last year and that could double to 9 million, yeah, it's an epidemic for us.
And why do you think it's growing so rapidly?
For a variety of reasons, but the two most important reasons are ease of access. Kids can get it on the internet and they can get it right in their home medicine cabinet. And the other problem we have is that kids and their parents as well don't view it as dangerous as an illicit drug. So they think it's safer than using an illegal street drug, which is absolutely false.
What are some of the harms that are caused by prescription drugs in the wrong doses?
Well, you can die. I mean, kids can overdose and die. And you mentioned our press conference today. We'll actually have a parent today that's going to talk about the situation she ran into with her son, who was 17 and overdosed on prescription drugs 6 years ago.
And McGregor, we were talking a little bit earlier about the availability of these drugs on the internet. Is there anything that the government can do to make sure that kids aren't getting on the computer and ordering these drugs?
Well, unfortunately, this is another aspect of the whole internet safety issue for our young people that we've been trying to bring attention to. There are pharmacies who you can literally log onto the website, they'll refer you to a doctor right there, and over the internet, online, you can get a prescription and the pharmacy will ship the drugs to you. There's no verification of age, there's no verification of identity, there's no face-to-face meeting with a doctor. And this creates a real problem because a 16-year-old kid can literally go online and order up all the painkillers he wants.
You don't have to know the pot dealer down the street.
Exactly. And that creates a real problem. And so we're trying to bring attention to this issue once again to really tell parents that they are the first line of defense on these issues of protecting their children from those who can potentially do them a great amount of damage on the internet.
Well, we'll have more on this a little bit later today when we follow the press conference, but you can also log on to kcra.com, and under the news link section, we've set up a link to the partnership's website, timetotalk.org. It's got great information in there for parents to open that line of communication with their kids and try to prevent this from happening in your home. Live in downtown Sacramento, I'm Brian Hickey. Back to you guys.
All right. Thank you, Brian.